guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So this is me doing an intro for a vlog which I shot 2 weeks ago, because back then I did not do an intro and I felt like the video needs a little bit of intro. So basically I got a chemical peel done, or I'm going to get a chemical peel done, like you will see in this video. So I got this peel done in Anu's clinic, Madhapur, Hyderabad. If you do want to check out the clinic, then I'll leave everything in the description box. You can check them out. I'll leave the Instagram also if you want to contact them. I feel the podologist there is extremely patient, hence I actually trusted and went ahead with the procedure. So if you're interested, then you can check it out. Now let's get into the vlog. Hi guys, so I am at Anu's today to get a chemical peel done. I thought I'll start this vlog while I was at home, but had no time, so I came here and I'm about to go in for the peel. I'm getting a yellow peel done. I've never gotten a yellow peel done before, so I'm a little scared but a little excited also. So my acne has been under control, but there are a lot of scarring which I want to get rid of. So the doctor here suggested me to go with a yellow peel, and that's what I'm going to do today. She's here, she's only going to do the peel. So yeah, I thought I'll show it to you guys, because you know, you might also be wondering what it is, how the procedure is. So I thought I'll take you through whatever happens so that you can also see what you're going to do if you get it done. So this is the scarring I have right now on both the sides, and the peel will help reduce the scars a lot quicker, because it helps rejuvenate the skin a lot quicker. So the procedure was quite simple. They just cleansed my skin and went in and applied this solution. I guess this is the yellow peel, the vitamin A solution, basically retinol, which helps peel the skin. Next, she added some kind of cream or moisturizer to the skin, and literally that was it. So just put on the peel. And I'm on the way back home. It literally just took 15 to 20 minutes to do. Not even 15 minutes, I think it was just done in 10 minutes. They applied the peeling solution, doctor applied it, and I was not supposed to wash it until like the next 8 hours, and then I can wash it off. So I'm about to wash my face, and that's what I'll show you. There's not much, but you know, in the sides, I have little like rough dead skin feeling type of thing which is coming. Can you see that? See, like that dead skin type of thing is coming. Like, but other than that, there's nothing else happening on my skin. I just have a little bit of mascara on because I had to shoot for something which I was not prepared for. I do not put makeup on my skin at all, just a little bit of mascara and lipstick, and I didn't put skin products. I'm just trying to remove the mascara without touching the skin, because I want to wash my face. Like, I'm not supposed to use a face wash today. I can use a face wash tomorrow. So I just have to wash it with water now and apply like moisturizer. It's a very slow process, because usually, like, you know, I can take like a pad and just put it on my face completely and it'll dissolve it, and I can wipe off all the makeup together. But now I should not touch the skin at all. Like, I don't think anything will happen, but you know, when they ask me not to, I don't want to. See, it is off. This one is amazing. I really love this micellar water, I always do. Very affordable and very nice. Okay guys, it's day 2. Ignore how like my hair looks, I just oiled it, and I realized I cannot wash my face. I cannot wash my hair, but I realized that after applying the oil, so you know, I look like this. So this is day two. There is nothing abnormal happening on my skin. Just looks like normal skin. Now, of course, I didn't expect anything like magical to happen with one peel, because peels are something which take time. You need to do like 3 to 4 times or more to even see results. But I just thought like I'll show you the procedure of it and how I felt during the peel. If there was any reaction, no reaction, ignore the clothes in the background. That's going to be there in everybody's house. If you're somebody who's going in for a peel and you're expecting some magical results, let me tell you that nothing is going to let that happen. It takes months for your skin to show results and, you know, see anything. Initially, if you're somebody who's never done anything to your skin, maybe like you'll see like a little bit of change. So yeah, anyway, that's the day two update. Hi guys. Okay guys, so I just woke up. Ignore my face. I just was brushing when I realized my skin started to peel around my nose. Yesterday was day two, nothing happened. Today is day three and there is slight peeling around my nose. I'm not sure if you can see. So, you know, there's slight peeling. I don't know why you cannot see it on camera, but you know, there is peeling happening around the nose. But other than that, nothing else is peeling. Only this nose part is. And that today is day three. Okay guys, so it is the same day, it is day three, but it's night time now and all the skin is peeling off.
It's like a chicken peeling skin.
Normal rest of the face is fine, only this part is peeling. Maybe tomorrow it'll peel more, but the rest of the face is fine. Like even around the nose area, it's there. Like morning I showed you, right? So this is how it looks from front camera. Front camera is not picking up so much, that's why I showed you guys in the mirror. So one thing I know, seeing hundreds of chemical peeling videos, of general skincare videos, is that you're not supposed to remove this skin physically. It'll go away on its own in a few days. You're not supposed to physically remove this. And I think like if you're washing your face and it's damp and you're washing, if it goes, then it's fine. But you cannot physically like peel off the dead skin. It's going to cause more hyperpigmentation and more skin issues. So I'm not gonna do anything to this. I just add maybe like a little bit of moisturizer or something. My lips are also a little bit dry. So yeah, that's day three. All right you guys, we are back home. It is almost 9:48, 10 o'clock. We left at 12 o'clock in the morning. So tired. My skin is in the weirdest state possible. Look at my skin, it is peeling all over. It is day four. Look at all this. I don't know what to do. It is 10 o'clock, but then my manager told me that I need to shoot something. I actually could not shoot for the past 4 days because of this thing. But today I have some submission to do. Basically, I'll give you a little update about the skin and that we're back home. Now I'm just going to be very, very tired, but I need to click a few pictures and yeah. So this side, you know, you can see it evidently, but on this side, it's like very, very light. Like you can see it like in person, but on camera, I'm not able to capture the dryness. So actually my doctor asked me to apply moisturizer like every 3 hours, every 3 to 4 hours, because skin tends to get dry. But I stepped out at 12 o'clock and I didn't do that. So probably that's why, and because of the mask and all also. I feel very weird. I just want to clean up first and then shoot a little bit. It is a day five and my skin is peeling on the forehead. You know, this is Instagram versus reality. Like my skin looks so good. Everything looks really nice and then you close up and it is all dry skin. It's peeling. Like yesterday was like this region and today is, you know, all this region. Ignore my brow hair, we're not here for my hair. See all this part. Probably I think this peeling will stop tomorrow because it's like sections of my face is done, like this part is done, so this part is getting done. I think tomorrow it should be all fine. Sorry, day six. Today is Saturday, I got it on Monday, so day six of the peel. So I just turned it into the back camera because I feel like front camera kind of makes everything look a lot better. I don't know how, but you know, you can see that there is a lot of dry skin here and here. Now, I have not shaved or done anything since a week because I have nothing to do, so ignore my head, but you can see there is a lot of dryness in this region as well. I hope you can see because I cannot see what you're seeing. And you know, there's a lot of dryness in this part, in this part, and like, you know. Hi you guys, another day. I just washed my hair. This Sunday I'm going out to meet my friends, so my skin is better today. There is at least, like, you know, a little bit of dryness going on the forehead and the chin. Even now the little flaky skin, you cannot see it like on camera or even like in mirror, but very very close up if you go, there's little flaky skin, just little dry skin basically. Today I'm going to put on makeup after 1 week. She actually told me I can put on makeup since yesterday, but I didn't have to do anything yesterday. My skin was peeling quite a bit, so I'm going to do makeup today. So this is my skin. Like you can see, there's, you know, a little bit of dryness there. Hi guys, so it's a week later. Basically it's been 2 weeks that I got my peel done, and I quickly wanted to summarize everything about the peel, my experience and more details. My voice is different because I got cold and it's almost gone, but still it kind of, you know, sounds a little different. So basically I got a yellow peel done. The doctor said yellow peel is basically a retinol peel and it's not like a acid peel, like a AHA, BHA peel, like, you know, usually you have glycolic acid peels, lactic acid peels, but this is a retinol peel. Now usually I've heard, this might not be the case, but retinol peels are kind of the safest because they don't like tend to burn your skin. The acids tend to do that. Like retinol is one of the best ingredients to, like, you know, rejuvenate your skin. It tends to make your skin a little more dry, but there's no chance that it's going to burn your skin as compared to like a glycolic acid, which might. Of course, everything done by a professional would always be a help and everything would give amazing result depending on who it, you know, which person is doing it. So this peel ranges between 3 to 5,000. It really depends from person to person because sometimes they give a mixture of things, sometimes they just give one thing. So you'll have to, like, you know, contact them. I leave all the, you know, details of the clinic I went to Anu's Madhapur. I've been going there like for some time, but this is the first time I got a peel done, and the dermatologist there is very like patient, and I really, like, you know, like how she answered my question, and that's the reason I trusted and went in for the you know, procedure. So I leave the, you know, details etc. in the description box if you want to check them out and go to the clinic and get any treatment done. So after like a week, also like on Sunday I showed you guys my skin, right? Even after that, for a couple more days I still had a little bit of dry skin, especially around the jaw area. My face area was quite fine, only right here I had a little bit of dry skin, but that was like very very minimal. And I really want to tell you guys about the skincare I used as well. So I actually recorded the bit where I was doing my skincare, but that footage is nowhere seen, so I'm just going to explain to you what I used. The post care after the peel was very simple. She just asked me to use a cleanser, a moisturizer and a sunscreen plus a hyaluronic acid serum if I have one. So I was using the simple face wash because it's very very gentle and the best thing I could do for my skin because my skin was kind of dry as well. It was like the most gentle thing. In the morning sometimes I was not even washing my face, I was just like cleansing it with water and leaving it. In the night I was using the simple face wash. So, and for moisturizer I was using the Be Minimalist moisturizer. She asked me to use something which has, like, you know, no irritant ingredients. She said either Clinique Moisture Surge or Neutrogena Water Boost. So I was, like, you know, switching up between Clinique and the Be Minimalist one because Be Minimalist one was also like no fragrance, no alcohol, no paraben, and I've been using that for like over 2 months and it kind of suited my skin quite well. And for sunscreen I was using the Neutrogena Zinc Sunscreen or the LA Shield the Zinc Sunscreen. I was switching up between these two. That was the post care. She just asked me to apply moisturizer like every 3 to 4 hours just to avoid, you know, dryness of the skin. If anything is fluttering, it is because of the fan. I know it's very annoying, but you know, ignore that. And yeah, this is my skin you guys. Like I recently had one more breakout, But yeah, this is the skin. I'm sure if I go in for more sessions, I'll see more results. So one thing you should be very, very sure of if you do this peel is that you should not go into the sun without sunscreen or direct, you know, it's better to avoid direct direct sunlight, because you know, your skin is sensitive. You just applied retinol on it. Retinol does make your skin a little bit sensitive, so it's better to avoid sun, especially like when you have it on and you, like, you know, the next 8 hours you're not supposed to wash it. Make sure you are, like, you know, protected until you go home. And like, I was there, like, I just put on my mask, my shades and a scarf while I was, like, in the cab coming home as well, so that my skin does not get any exposure to the sun, except like when I was, like, shooting that small bit. And the next, like, 3 to 4 days, I'm blessed enough to stay at home, so I was, like, I completely avoided sunlight for the next 3 to 4 days as well. But if you do go out, then, you know, make sure you apply sunscreen. Even when, if you're indoor, if you have a lot of lighting in your house, then make sure you apply sunscreen. So yeah, that was my experience of yellow peel done. Make sure you please consult a good dermatologist and do this. Don't go to any random place and get this done. Make sure there's a professional who's going to help you and do this on you. So yeah, I hope this video was useful. If I do more, if I, you know, get anything else done, I'll of course take you through that journey and show, you know, things with my skin. I will always do that. And yeah, with that, we finished this video. If you like this video, then make sure you like, share, and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell. All the details will be in the description, and I'll see you guys in my next video.